going to go live for you automatically. So just go to the right hand side of the page and select go live. Now, staying on the right side of the page here, you're going to see some additional features. One of those is to create a highlight video. So after you've streamed for longer than a minute, you're going to have the ability going to go live for you. Start streaming. So just go to the right hand side of the page and select go live. Now, staying on the right side of the page, streaming, and we're off and live. If you schedule a stream, it's not going to go live for you automatically. So just go to the right hand side of the page and select go live. Now, staying on the right side of the page here, you're going to see some additional features. One of those is to create a highlight video. So after you've streamed for longer than a minute, you're going to have the ability to go back to portions of your live stream to be able to capture those highlight moments and then upload that in the form of a video, public or even unlisted. Next to that, you have the ability to add a stream marker, which is basically just bookmarking a certain time of the stream. You have the ability to share your stream to different platforms, as well as being able to copy the link to your stream. Within the chat itself, you as the creator have some additional features. You can pop out the chat window in case you want to move your chat dialogue to different areas of your desktop. You can also manage comments by selecting the three dotted icon next to someone's name in the chat, giving you the ability to pin their comment, make them mod, or even ban them from the channel. At the bottom of your chat, you have the ability to create a poll, which is relatively new, but really cool, and it helps engage your chat even more in deciding what things to do on the stream. But now, if you're all done with your stream, just go ahead.